In this video lecture, we are going to discuss digestion and absorption of lipids. So in a typical diet, we consume 25 to 160 grams of lipids. That's 90% triglycerides. The lipids that we ingest, we have to digest. So lipids face very special problems in digestion and absorption. And the reason for that is because they're not water soluble. Remember that carbohydrates and proteins are water soluble. So the problem with lipids then, because they're not water soluble, they don't mix with the stomach or the intestinal contents, and they tend to form water droplets. Remember that lipids are lipophilic. That means they're hydrophobic. So that presents a little bit of a problem to us. And we're going to figure out, or we will discuss how lipids get around this, or how our body has adapted so that we can digest and absorb these lipids. So the enzymes that are necessary for lipid digestion are called lipase. We have three different types of lipase. There is lingual lipase, so that's secreted from the mouth. We also have another form of lipase called gastric lipase, that's secreted from the stomach. And then we also have our third enzyme, which is perhaps our most important one, and that's pancreatic lipase. And as you could guess from the name, that is secreted from the pancreas. When it's secreted from the pancreas, it will then enter into the duodenum. So pancreatic lipase actually functions in the duodenum to break down fat, but it is synthesized and secreted by the pancreas. The most important of these, or where does most lipid digestion occur, and most lipid digestion occurs in the duodenum. So lipases only act on molecules near the edge of the fat droplet. And so if you have a large fat droplet and lipases are only acting near the edge of this very large fat droplet, it's going to take a very long time to break down this fat. So what we have to aid or to assist with lipid digestion are bile salts. So bile salts are going to take this very large fat droplet and break it down into smaller droplets. Bile salts have increased the surface area, so now these enzymes that, remember, only function near the edge of the fat droplet, they have a lot more surface area, right, to try to digest this lipid. So this process where bile salts take a large droplet and break it down into smaller droplets, this process is called emulsification. So let's focus then on these bile salts. So bile salts are synthesized in the liver from cholesterol. So one of the reasons that cholesterol is necessary, right? You can't cut out all the cholesterol in your diet. The bile salts then get secreted in the bile to the duodenum, right? Where the liver, which produces the bile, and the gallbladder, which stores the bile, when bile leaves the gallbladder or leaves the liver, how does it make it to the duodenum? Be sure you understand what structures that passes through and what sphincters have to be open in order for this to happen. Okay, so bile salts are what we call an amphipathic molecule. And so you learned about amphipathic molecules when you learned about the phospholipid bilayer. So remember, an amphipathic molecule is a molecule that has both a polar side and a nonpolar side, rather, and a polar side for you. And the function for the bile salt then is to emulsify that fat. And it's able to do that because the polar ends get attracted to water, and then the nonpolar end is afraid of the water. So you'll see shortly how this bile salt will bind to a fat droplet. So before, here we have a large fat droplet, okay? Very little surface area, right, is exposed to lipases. And now we have the bile salts. Notice the direction that they're binding. The nonpolar part of the bile salt is here. So that's the part that's lipid soluble. Notice where it's binding to the fat droplet. It is the nonpolar side of your bile salt. So it binds to the lipid. Lipophilic things bind to lipids, right? The other side of your bile salt, on this side here, this is the side that's polar. Right? And it's important that it orients that way because outside here is a whole bunch of water molecules, right, with charges on it. And that explains why these bile salts orient the way that they do. So these bile salts then, because they are amphipathic, can take this large fat droplet and break it down into smaller fat droplets. So remember that this bile is dropped or dumped into the duodenum. So this is why most lipid digestion occurs in the duodenum, because that's where you have bile salts emulsifying your fat, which makes it easier for your lipase to act. There is no bile in your mouth, normally, and there is no bile in your stomach, normally. So let's take a look at how lipase acts then. How does it break down this fat droplet? We're going to assume, here we already have your bile salts that are bound to this fat droplet. So you have several bile salts already bound. Now your lipase needs to come in and bind to the fat. So here they're illustrating to you lipase and how it's interacting with one triglyceride. And so lipase is going to take that triglyceride. So when we break down a triglyceride using lipase, we're going to be getting monoglycerides and fatty acids. Okay, so they're no longer coupled together, right? So now what happens? So here we see how you have your fatty acid. And that fatty acid, remember, those are lipophilic. So fatty acids can freely diffuse across that epithelial cell. Once they get inside of the cell, their ultimate goal is to diffuse all the way over into the blood, right? You want to absorb these into the blood. We're going to come back to that. Now, not all of your fatty acids are going to be absorbed right away. Some of the fatty acids that do not freely diffuse right away, they're not absorbed. What's going to happen with them is they're going to aggregate with bile salts and cholesterol and some other lipid-soluble substances. And when they all aggregate, what we're going to call this aggregation is a micelle. As your fatty acids get absorbed, and the body needs to start absorbing more fatty acids, the micelle can actually release more products to be absorbed. So the micelle may release this fatty acid and then it may get absorbed. Okay, but that's as the body needs it. Let's go ahead and return to the situation where we freely diffuse our fatty acids, or our lipid, right? Our lipid into the epithelial cell. Remember, the goal is to get this lipid across and into the blood. And let's look at how this happens. Here comes your monoglyceride and your free fatty acid, right? And we know how they got across the apical membrane by freely diffusing. Now what happens to them? So they're going to enter into this organelle here called the smooth ER, which you're familiar with. Okay, remember that the smooth ER does a lot with fat, right? It synthesizes triglycerides. That's its function. In step two, the smooth ER is going to reassemble the triglyceride. We broke it down before, now we're going to reassemble it. So that reassembled triglyceride then, I'm going to label this in number three, enters the Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus then, we know, modifies and packages and sends it out. When it gets exported, it's exported as a chylomicron. So this chylomicron contains the triglyceride, the modified triglyceride. So it's in a vesicle, right? That's what this chylomicron looks like. It looks like a secretory vesicle. So the way for any secretory vesicle to get out of a cell is via exocytosis. So number four here is exocytosis. So this cell has to exocytose the chylomicron that contains your modified triglyceride. This chylomicron is too large to go directly into the blood. So the chylomicron is going to bypass the blood completely, and it's going to enter a structure called the lacteal. Lacteals are blind-ended lymphatic vessels that are in the villus of the small intestine. So now we have this chylomicron that's inside of this lacteal, and it enters into the lymphatic system. So once that chylomicron gets into the lymphatic system, the lymphatic system is directly connected to circulation, to the bloodstream. So this triglyceride then enters into the blood via the lymphatic system. Then it's going to go where? Where do we store fat? Well, we store fat in adipose tissue. And when necessary, we can break it down to use it as a source of energy as well. These triglycerides can also be stored in other cells as well. So we talked about bile salts, and we talked about how the liver produces these bile salts and they get stored in the gallbladder. And then when needed, they pass through the common bile duct, through the ampulla of Vater, and through an open sphincter of Oddi. So when they leave the common bile duct and they pass through the open sphincter of Oddi, they enter into the duodenum. So the bile salts do their job. Okay, they emulsify the fat. And the thing about these bile salts is we can recycle them. When the bile salts reach the ileum, they can be absorbed back into circulation. So they go back into the circulation and they go back to the liver. And that way you can recycle them, right? And then you can secrete the bile salts again without having to make new ones. This video once again described the digestion and absorption of lipids. And this concludes the video. I hope this was helpful.